Yeah, hi everyone. This is Prabhat Kumar. I'm your host today, and the topic of today's webinar is Fast Track to Digital Business and Accelerated Innovation. So we'll understand what this topic is all about. Actually, we are trying to help you how you can move to a digital organization quickly and effectively. So before we start, how we can do that? We'll try to understand what all challenges today's environment is posing in front of discrete manufacture and process industries. So any organization need to reduce the development cost now to stay competitive. They need to improve productivity, and obviously the quality should be consistent. So when we talk about these three requirements of organization, what could be a quick fix? If you have product lifecycle management system in place, it will help you achieve these three objectives, like reducing development cost, improving productivity, and increase quality. But when you go towards a product lifecycle management system, you need to go through a journey. So the stages or steps of those journeys are, you need to do the selection of the PLM tool, then you have to select the vendor who is going to implement that PLM software, then you need to invest into the software licenses and the hardware infra and the implementation partners, implementation services. So again, you have to invest a cap, you need to go for a capex investment. Then you need to finalize the scope of the work, which need to be completed. Then you need to bring in the infrastructure, the hardware, the operating systems, the database, and the space, the air conditioning, the administration people to manage these resources. Then the actual deployment will start. It will take certain time, maybe 3 months or 6 months or 1 year. Once the deployment is completed, now there will be a certain learning curve. Then only you will be able to achieve the actual return on your investment, which has gone into all these stages. So what could be a better idea so that you can easily transform your organization from a manufacturing organization to a digital manufacturing organization or a digital organization? How you can accelerate the innovation which you are doing for your product development? So Siemens has introduced one solution called Teamcenter X, which is a SaaS platform, that means software as a service. And today we'll understand how this Teamcenter X can accelerate your journey towards a digital organization. So these are the benefits which Teamcenter X brings to you. Because it's a SaaS platform, it is an instant on PLM opportunity for your organization. Like, you need not worry about all those stages which we discuss in a traditional PLM implementation practices. You need not worry about the hardware and then implementation and then maintaining and managing those infrastructure and the implemented solution. That everything will be taken care by Siemens. It comes with a proven solution which Siemens has acquired in a couple of decades of exposure and experience with these manufacturing companies. And again, scalability is never a challenge with this solution. You can start small with basic level of data and design management and process management, but when you want to expand into the full-blown PLM capabilities, it is always scalable. Third benefit Teamcenter X brings to you is the Mendix Locate Code platform, which is inbuilt part of the solution. Mendix is a platform wherein to create different dashboard or to collect information from different enterprise software other than PLM as well. Not much coding is required. It can be done by a business user itself. It also brings the benefit of artificial intelligence to your PLM solution. So as I told you, that Siemens has acquired certain experience during its exposure to manufacturing organization in last couple of decades during implementation of digital manufacturing and PLM solution at this organization. And what Siemens has done, those learning they have captured, they have put as a pre-configured solution inside this Teamcenter X, so that your implementation time and scoping time is drastically reduced and you can quickly start using this solution. So these are the different levels of Teamcenter X implementation. Like when you say Teamcenter X base, it comes with basic data and process management capabilities. You can do document management, you can do revision management, your bill of material management, the process management, the visualization of 3D products. So those all come with Teamcenter X base, and then as per your organization need, you can add further add-ons. Like you want to manage your mechanical CAD or electronics CAD, then you can do CAD data management. For change management, there is add-on. For classification and library management, add-ons are available. So as per your organization need, you can start with basic management or you can start with some add-on. And if you believe that you want to go full blown PLM, then there are personalization option available. Like you can integrate your Teamcenter X to your ERP and other enterprise system. You can go with advanced configuration and customization capabilities. So now we'll understand how this Teamcenter X can help you achieve these capabilities. So Teamcenter X comes with these many capabilities, like design management, whether it is a mechanical CAD or electronics or electrical CAD. Similarly, it helps in document management and bill of material management and the visualization of your 3D components and documents. Then change and process management and automation of those processes. And then once you completed the basic level of your data and document management and process management, you can always scale to the other additional capabilities of full-blown product lifecycle management. So when we talk about design data management, it can integrate with all the best-in-class CAD tools, whether it is mechanical CAD or electrical or electronics CAD. It also give you benefit of multi-domain digital twin management. That means within one bill of material you can have mechanical, electrical, electronics and embedded software managed. So now we'll start with the design information management. So what benefit this Teamcenter X is bringing to you, that this will go and sit embedded inside your native CAD management tool. Okay, and then whatever intelligence you are capturing during the creation of those product or assemblies or component inside your CAD tool, those are captured by Teamcenter X, and then it is managed inside a cloud-based environment. So like today, right now I'm showing you this NX data management, but similar thing will apply for other CAD tools also, like Creo or SolidWorks or SolidEdge or Inventor. So this software will be embedded inside your native CAD software, and from there itself you will be able to take advantage of data and process management capabilities of this software. So like in this example I'm showing you, this is an NX interface. Within NX interface you have got Teamcenter X capabilities. Now you're searching for a handle here, so you just started typing. Then it is given the results of your search. Now you are using the filtering capabilities of the search solution, and then you have located this handle. And once you locate it, you can overview and review it, and then once you are satisfied, you can open this into your NX CAD environment. Now you see that this handle is having a right hand side housing missing, so you want to add that. Now you are searching for that housing, you have located that housing using search capability, and then you say I want to add this housing to my product which I'm working on. So once you have added this component from Teamcenter to your NX assembly, your bill of material inside NX is updated, and parallelly same bill of material is updated inside Teamcenter environment also. From here you can send it for review and approval. That means the process management is also part of your Nitticad software itself. And once you submit it, it will go to the respective stakeholders for review and approval and comment. In a similar fashion, here this is the example of SOLIDWORKS, wherein Teamcenter is embedded inside your SOLIDWORKS environment. Now I'm searching for a battery which is missing for this hand drill, and I want to add this battery to my hand drill assembly. Once I located that battery, I just drag and drop or maybe select and add to my assembly, and then I can use my SOLIDWORKS assembly capabilities to position it at the proper place. System is also recording when I'm making any changes to my assembly, it is also recording those steps. Now I want to create a drawing for this assembly of hand drill. Now this templates of drawings will come from Teamcenter to ensure the standardization across organization. And now I'm creating my views for those hand drills, and all these activities Teamcenter is recording, and Teamcenter is also ensuring that there is a traceability between your product 3D models and your drawings. And once you save this drawing, the system will automatically create a PDF of this drawing which can be used to distribute among the downstream people who are not having access to Teamcenter. So this is the PDF which system has created. Now you can share this PDF to downstream people who may not have access to Teamcenter or SOLIDWORKS environment. So this sort of automation it can bring to your CAD data management. Similarly, if you are using electrical or electronic CAD software also, because nowadays your product may be having mechanical, electrical, electronics and software embedded. So if you have any CAD software, so that also can be managed seamlessly using Teamcenter X. So here I'm giving the example of Mentor pads to manage or design PCB, but similarly if you have other PCB designing software like Altium or Allegro or OrCAD, that also can be seamlessly managed using Teamcenter software. So now in the similar fashion, if you see Teamcenter is available inside your Mentor pads environment. Now you are searching for one component. Here again I am searching for hand drill only, but this time this I would be searching information which is related to my PCB design. So this time I am searching a printed circuit assembly. Once I located a printed circuit assembly which belongs to my hand drill, I can review it, understand it in detail. This is the complete bill of material which I am able to see within Teamcenter interface before I open this assembly into my PCB design environment. So now I located this capacitor, then using this attachment tab I am able to see the documents related to that capacitor. Various will tell me this capacitor is used in other parent assemblies also. So I am opening those assembly inside my PCB design software. So see, now I have my complete PCB assembly project open inside my PCB designing software. I can see different schematic, whether it is battery production schematic or controller or motor drive schematic. Everything has been opened from Teamcenter to my PCB designing software. And I can do further activities also using my Teamcenter embedded into my PCB designing software. When it comes to change management, because change management is not a simple activity inside an organization. A lot many organizational stakeholders are involved which need to be reviewing or approving any change which is happening. So Teamcenter change management is CM2 certified, which is a gold standard for change management, and it also helps you achieve full traceability of change across the enterprise, and you can take advantage of impact analysis. We'll understand in coming slide. So when you're using Teamcenter change management, in the dashboard itself it is telling you how your organization is doing when it comes to change management. Like you can understand how many change notices are in progress or how many change requests are in progress. In last week how many changes has been completed, or when we say from the maturity point of view, how many change are complete, how many change are at the execution stage. You can see the complete list of change also at the bottom of this dashboard, wherein it is giving you the picture how many changes are in progress, at what maturity stage those are, what is the creation date, at what date it was modified or approved. So you can get the complete holistic picture of the changes which are happening inside your organization. Now if you want to evaluate the change in detail, you can open that change in a new window, and then it will tell you at what stage this change has reached. Under impact analysis, it will tell you these are the candidates which can get impacted because of the problem item which you are working on, and from there the respective stakeholder will decide which should actually be added to the impacted item. When you decide something, it is also giving you related object like document or other component or assembly which are getting impacted. So it is giving you opportunity to add those also to the impacted item. So now if we see, we have added three impacted items here to this change. One is the handle assembly, second is this gearbox, and third one is the document which is owner manual for this basic drill. So now if you go to the affected item list, it is listing all the impacted item. The problem item is the one which was the cause of initiation of this change. Now the system, whenever you make any changes or revision to your impacted item, system will understand that because you are working in context of a change, and it will by default add those changes to your solution item. So we have selected this assembly and we are revising it. Previously it was revision A, now I'm revising it to B. So now system will add this new revision B to my change. So I need not manually add those change into my solution. Now under this bill of material, this complete gearbox which was again impacted item is being replaced. So previously it was some other gearbox, but I'm using a new gearbox in place of the previous one. Now if you see here, you can see because I have revised the drill, so now new revision has become solution item. Similarly, because I have replaced the gearbox, the new gearbox which I am going to use has become the solution item. Similarly for this document also which I am revising. Now if you come to this overview tab and you expand the change summary, now the system is giving you the complete detail or complete traceability. Like previously you were using the revision A, now it is revision B for this change being implemented. If any component has been removed or any component has been revised, it is giving you the complete history or change summary, what all happened during this change execution. And as we know, any design is not complete unless its documentation is complete. So now Teamcenter gives you the similar capabilities on the document management side also. So here I am giving you example of MS Word, but same is true for MS Excel and MS PowerPoint also. Like we have seen that this Teamcenter is embedded into your designing tool. Similarly, the Teamcenter is embedded into your documentation tool also, like MS Word or Excel or PowerPoint. So under Teamcenter tab, if you are saving something, it will go and be saved under your product information inside Teamcenter. If you want to send this document for review, so you can select the workflow or business process and it will go to the respective manager for review and approval. If you go to Teamcenter browser-based interface, now you are searching a motor here, but this time you are not searching for the component, you are searching a document related to motor. So you can select the accordingly the category and it will give you the information. Now you have located the document, again system will convert your MS Word to PDF if the need be. And here if the manager is seeing that some modification need to be done on this PDF document. He can use the capability of markup, wherein he would be commenting on the respective area, putting these markups and giving his comments what need to be changed. Now the respective engineer would get the information and he would be making the desired modification. Now from document you can reach to the respective component, and from component you can come back to the document which is related to this component. And the respective person who is working on the document, he'll be able to see that comment which is coming from the manager, and according to those comments he would be able to make changes to the document. Similarly, it will help you to do the process management and the automation of those business processes. Like we have already seen, you can initiate the release process, it will go to the respective manager for review and approval, and every activity which is being conducted will be recorded by the system. Similarly, on the bill of material side, it will give you the capability of multi-domain bill of material management, wherein you can manage under a single bill of material all the mechanical, electrical, electronics and embedded software component. So here we are seeing the same handled bill of material. Under electrical, all the electronics and electrical you are managing. Under attachment, you are able to see the respective documents. If you want to visualize this handrail, you can do that. Then you can use these basic visualization capabilities like hiding and showing components, and zooming, panning and rotating to understand the 3D in detail without actually consuming your CAD software license. And then you can do other activities like measurement or sectioning to further analyze your design. If you want to locate certain component within your big assembly, you can use navigation option. It will help you locate this motor inside your handrail. Now if you have selected this motor inside handrail, then respective information you can locate. You can also locate this subcomponent is used in what all other products. If you want to work only on the bill of material, then you can hide the respective visualization tab, and then you can explore the complete bill of material in a single tabular interface, wherein it is giving you information about the complete bill of material along with the other information like who is owning the component or subassembly, when it was released, and what is the release status. Okay, and obviously inside an organization, if you have created a lot of design in last couple of years or couple of decades and you are not able to reuse those information or design, then you are actually increasing the cost for the organization, because you are increasing inventory cost, you are creating duplication of data and efforts. So if the system should be able to give you a search and reuse capability. So Teamcenter X come with all these search capabilities, we'll see in next slide. If you want to locate information, so this is a search wherein you are searching, and similar to Google, it is giving you suggestion. Then if you see, it has given you results in a categorized form, like you have searched for cap, but it is giving you whether you want a part or document or file. If you see on the left side, it looks like a shopping cart. Like if you are searching on your shopping cart, whether it is Amazon or some other shopping cart. So if you are searching for a mobile, then you will decide, okay, I want to go for iOS or Android phone. Then this should be the screen size, this should be the processor. So you are giving those filters, and based on those filters, your shopping cart is narrowing the search and then giving this to you. In similar fashion, this Teamcenter is giving you filters, and you can use those filters to locate the information easily and quickly. So like this time I've selected document, but if I want, I can go there and can select the category to parts. Okay, then I want to give further criteria like what all parts which has been approved, and once I located my component, I can see the information there itself. I can see under this classification tab, this component belongs to which library category. It will also give me a respective document information under attachment tab. Various will help me locate the parent assembly this component belongs to. Similarly, now I'm searching for some other component. So once I've located that component, I can open it to further investigate and understand. Again, within where used, it is letting me know that this component belongs to this PCB assembly. Now I have the PCB assembly bill of material in front of me. I can also visualize the 3D of that PCB assembly. And now I can go to the where used tab once again, and I can see this PCB assembly is used in this product, which is handheld. Now I'm at the product level bill of material, where I can see my mechanical, electrical, electronics, and even embedded software in a single bill of material. And then I can do the further activities here itself. This is a very beautiful feature of Teamcenter X, which is called Active Assistant. And as I already told you, that Mendix is adding artificial intelligence capabilities to Teamcenter. This is the result of that. So this artificial intelligence is giving you these many benefits, like it will predict the command for you, it will reduce the mouse clicks by at least 30%, and it will also learn activities from you and your team. And then a new user who is going to use this solution, this artificial intelligence Teamcenter assistant would be guiding him. So like here I have selected team recent, that means how my team is performing or using this solution. Now the team was working on these many solution product. I located this handrail from there itself. Now I started using Teamcenter. If you see on the left side under assistant, it is suggesting me what command to use rather than I am searching for the command, because it has learned all those activities from my team members. So this way it will help me or guide me to perform my activities. And all those commands are updating as I'm moving forward with my activities. So isn't it a good idea that one guide is always sitting inside Teamcenter, who is letting you know what you should be doing next, what command you should be using. So today I discuss about the basic capabilities of Teamcenter X, and these are the benefits which you are going to achieve. Like, because it's a cloud based system, you are going to get all other benefits of cloud which comes along with the cloud based system, like high availability and durability. And again, this is a scalable solution. You need not worry about the scalability, because you can start with basic level of design data management or process management, but when you want to scale it to the full-blown PLM, it is always capable of doing that. And again, it is very secure, because security is managed inside the cloud. Again, cloud vendor is secure in the system, and then Siemens SaaS team is also working on the data security and IP protection, so you need not worry about that as well. And as I already told you, it comes with software as a service and pre-configured solution, so you can quickly adopt it, and then finally you can scale very fast as your need increases. So with this, I'll summarize today's activities which we discussed. Like, it is an instant on PLM solution. You can quickly start using PLM. It is quite scalable. You can grow as per your need. And it comes with Mendix low code platform, which gives you benefit like artificial intelligence. So when you say compare your Teamcenter X, which is software as a service, to traditional PLM on-premise system, so for on-premise PLM you need to worry about data, you need to worry about applications which are being deployed, then there would be runtime which are required for those applications, then you need to arrange for database, operating system, you need to arrange physical server, then you need to build virtualization on top of that, you need to ensure the proper networking and storage. So like you are creating a complete data center, which is the accountability is onto you. And in case of Teamcenter X, which is a SaaS platform, you need not worry about infra and other things. You need to worry only about the data which is coming from your innovation team. Rest everything will be taken care by Siemens SaaS team, whether it is application or infrastructure or virtualization, those will be taken care by Siemens team. So this way you are reducing your accountability and you are focusing on the activities which are actually important from the innovation point of view. So with this, I would like to wish you an accelerator innovation platform, which is Teamcenter X. Hope this platform would be really useful for your organization to quickly move on to product data management and product lifecycle management capabilities. So we are always available to you. You can always reach out to us. You can reach out to me on my mail ID, or you can reach out to us on our corporate mail ID, or you can follow us on our LinkedIn and Facebook page.